things that happen in military divorce do not necessarily happen in non-military divorces. For example, there are issues of different compensation. Some of them get combat pay, some of them get housing, some of them get certain dependent allowances. How does that factor into alimony and child support? The second issue they often face is custody. What happens when they're deployed? What happens when they get sent on certain assignments? Yes, we have to honor that military member's service, but we also have to take into consideration the needs of stability for the child. Where is that balance struck? The third area that they sometimes have to struggle with, particularly when there's allegations of domestic violence, whether those allegations are true or not true, those allegations in and of themselves impact that military person's ability to carry a weapon. People in the military have special circumstances, they need special considerations, and they need attorneys that understand where they are coming from, their other obligations, and how to try and move their family forward.